Okay, now it's 10. I can start my explanation. So, yesterday I gave you an introduction about the quality of a fuel. Okay, and yesterday we have discussed about the fractional distillation of petroleum or crude oil. Okay, which we mine it from the sea or oceanic beds. Okay, and refine it in different stages. First part of the reforming with refining would be removal of water, removal of sulfur compounds, and removal of dissolved salts present in it. Removal of water is done by a famous method called as Cotterell's method. Okay, there I have told with you that an emulsion of crude oil or petroleum with water, that is brine water, is passed through heavy electric plates, okay, which will remove water to the edges, whereas the organic crude oil will be tapped from the center of that apparatus or instrument. Okay, next we'll be removing sulfur based compounds, adding copper compounds, particularly that of copper oxide. Okay, what you'll realize is that sulfur is removed as copper sulfide, followed by removal of sodium or potassium and magnesium salts, dissolved salts, by desalting process that could be done by a complexing reagents. Okay, and hence is the preliminary refining of the crude oil or petrol. Now the actual process comes in when I am doing fractional distillation. Okay, what is fractional distillation? Separation of different fractions of crude oil or petroleum or any liquid depending upon their boiling range is called as fractional distillation. And yesterday we have seen, when I have done fractional distillation of the crude oil or petroleum by passing the vapors into a long drawn tower having bubble caps, there was a component which came out of the huge tower from the top as gas. That is the LPG, which is nothing but the uncondensed gas. followed by the petroleum ether fraction, which is a very, very low boiling range fraction, which gets separated next in the tower. Okay, followed by petrol, okay, or commonly called as gasoline, followed by kerosene, diesel, followed by the heavy oil fractions. Okay, so the discussion stopped there. Why? For us, commercially important fractions are petrol, diesel, and kerosene. Obviously, they are the fuels for the whole entire world. Okay, so and out of which petrol and diesel dictate the automobile industry. Okay, and hence was the discussion. Then we evaluated the properties of these three fractions. As I've told yesterday, petrol is C5 to C9 component, whereas kerosene is C10 to C14, and diesel is C10 to C16 or 18 component. Okay, whereas the boiling range of petrol is less, 40 to 120 degrees centigrade, followed by kerosene 180 to 250. And diesel, of course, 250 to 320 degrees centigrade with the boiling range. Followed by the calorific value of this fuel, 11,250 kilocals per kg is the calorific value of petrol, followed by 11,100 kerosene, and 11,000 is the calorific value of diesel. Okay, and hence is the rating. Fine. Out of which we focused about the petrol as the main component, and I told with you the petrol that is obtained commercially by fractional distillation is just the 20% supply of the entire demand. That's it. A small component is catered by fractional distillation. So petrol is prepared either synthetically by two methods called as Fischer-Tropsch process or Burgess process, or it is obtained by another method called as cracking. Okay, in cracking process is done by three ways: thermal cracking, hydro cracking, and catalytic cracking. What you have in your syllabus is catalytic cracking, which is done by two ways. One is fixed bed catalytic cracking. The other one is moving bed catalytic cracking. Yesterday I described the moving bed catalytic cracking in depth. Okay, where you take the middle oil and heavy oil fractions of this fractional distillation, and you will subject them to the breaking process. Okay, what is being done? It is first vaporized at around 500 to 530 degrees centigrade. Okay, then it is passed into a chamber containing catalyst, maintained also at the temperature of 500 to 530 degrees centigrade and a pressure of 3 to 5 kilocals, kgs per centimeter square. Okay, there the vapors of the heavy oil and middle oil are churned along with the catalyst. Okay, the catalyst generally includes kiesel guhar clay, aluminium oxide, along with that zirconium, cobalt, molybdenum, nickel, etc. 3D metals are taken. Why? For greater adsorption of the gases or vapors on their surface, and hence increasing the catalytic surface of the medium. Okay, the catalyst along with the vapors of the oil fractions and also are churned in such a way that the vapors get cracked, and the lighter vapors are thrown out of the chamber from the top with the help of a cyclotron. Now, during this cracking process, lot of carbon is deposited onto the catalytic bed, which slowly gets deposited to the bottom of the chamber. The gases that are pumped out of the cyclotron or cracking chamber are now passed into a fractionating tower. Again, the fractionating tower does the activity. It separates the various cracking fractions, followed by tapping off the petrol fraction. Okay, I'll tap the gases of the petrol fraction, condense that in a cooler, followed by its their passage into a stabilizer, which removes any gases by chance if they are present. The petrol that thus obtained is a very good quality petrol, having very high yields. Now, one more point, I think yesterday, did I discuss that the catalyst can be regenerated. How? By burning the carbon that got deposited at 600 degrees centigrade. That is the efficiency of moving by catalytic process. Okay. And yesterday I stopped my discussion with giving you the importance of catalytic cracking. Okay, the advantages of catalytic cracking. Sometimes it's being asked as a 2 or 3 marks question. Okay, and hence was the discussion. After understanding that the petrol is obtained, what we are doing is we are actually using the petrol as the fuel. Okay, but what we should realize is that it can't be used just like that, because the quality of petrol really dictates the efficiency, okay, of combustion. So fine. So how I'm actually purifying petrol or making petrol very much viable for the automobiles, okay, by another process called as reforming. I'm not discussing about that because it is out of the syllabus. But then I want to evaluate the quality of petrol and diesel, which are actually acting as fuels for our vehicles. Okay, and hence is the discussion. Then I told yesterday with you, okay, the quality of petrol and diesel is, if by chance is not good, okay, or just used like that, what will happen? It leads to a rattling sound called knocking. Okay, why knocking? Rattling sound made by the internal combustion engines due to improper burning of the fuel is nothing but knocking. Now, why knocking takes place? In the case of petrol, it is premature ignition, whereas in the case of diesel, it is delayed ignition that leads to knocking of the IC engines. Okay, and obviously knocking will be directly proportional to the quality of the fuel. So greater the quality of the fuel, lesser, okay, will be the knocking. Adhe direct anala, indirect anala. Inversely kada, greater the quality of the fuel, lesser is the knocking. Okay, so inversely, okay, good quality petrol does not give much knocking. Okay, and hence is the discussion. Okay, next, how to judge the quality of petrol and diesel? Okay, so next point, rating is important. Rating of petrol and diesel. Rating of petrol and diesel. Okay. Petrol is rated by a number called as octane number or octane rating. Petrol is given octane rating. Okay. Considering the knocking properties of two compounds, okay, N-heptane and isooctane. Okay, in this case, N-heptane 100% knocking. N-heptane 100% knocking, okay, whereas octane is given 0% knocking. Okay, isooctane is given the 0% knocking. Okay, what I'm telling with you, I'll rate petrol for its quality. Okay, the rating that I give is called as octane rating. Okay, octane rating is given in terms of the knocking properties of two compounds. One is N-heptane and the other one is isooctane. what you should understand is that N-heptane has 100% knocking, so its octane number is zero. Whereas isooctane has this 0% knocking, therefore its octane number is 100. So octane number is 0 here. Okay, the octane number is 100% here. Octane number is 100. Okay. Hope you have understood the table. Please do take it. Very important. Octane number and cetane number for petrol and diesel respectively. What you should write their word. Okay. Octane rating is given considering the knocking properties of N-heptane and isooctane. I shall give you the definition while explaining. But write down this flow chart right now. Okay, this flow chart relation flow. Fine. Next, what you have here is the rating of diesel. I hope you have already taken this. Okay, now after writing the description there, okay, please take down the definition for octane number. Definition of octane number. Right? Octane number is defined as the percentage of isooctane, the percentage of isooctane present in a mixture of present in a mixture of isooctane and N-heptane present in a mixture of isooctane and N-heptane. Did you take down the definition there? What is octane rating? It is a percentage of isooctane present in a mixture of isooctane and N-heptane. That's the definition there. Okay, fine. It's important. So I'm just giving you the flow charts a little more elaborately. Very important, I'd say. Okay, next, diesel is rated for its quality by giving cetane rating, or cetane number is generally said. Octane number and cetane number are the commonly used ones. Okay. And here also, what they'll get is 2-methyl, they'll give the cetane rating considering two molecules. Knocking properties of two molecules, 2-methyl naphthalene, okay, this compound has 100% knock. This compound has 100% knocking, okay, so cetane value is 0. cetane number is 0. Okay. There is another compound, aliphatic compound, that is hexadecane. N-hexadecane. Is the board clear to all of you? Okay. The other one is N-hexadecane. Okay. And its cetane rating is 100 and 0% not. Cetane number is 100. Okay. And hence is the Did you take down the flow charts? Okay. So the flow chart should contain what is knocking, why knocking in the case of petrol, why knocking in the case of diesel, and knocking, I'd say, is inversely proportional to the quality of petrol. That is, greater the quality of petrol, lesser is knocking. Okay. That's the idea. And I'll rate petrol and diesel depending upon So when I'm explaining this topic, I need to introduce you to what are the technical terms that are used. Okay. In the case of petrol, it is octane rating or octane number, and the octane number is given by the percentage of isooctane present in a combination of N-heptane and isooctane. Okay. So, hope you have taken the definition for cetane number. Right. Cetane rating. Cetane rating. Or cetane number. It is the percentage of hexadecane. It is the percentage of hexadecane present in a mixture of hexadecane and 2-methylnaphthalene. It is the percentage of hexadecane, N-hexadecane, in a mixture of N-hexadecane and 2-methylnaphthalene. Okay. So that's about the flowchart for knowing the rating of petrol. But the discussion is incomplete if I don't describe at length what and how I am giving. So, right? Petrol ni octane rating is tunnan an chappi. So, definition chappesan. Enti octane number ela istan ante octane rating oka test sample of petrol isthunna. Ichar evaro meeku. So, right? ఇచ్చిన తర్వాత దాని నాకింగ్ ప్రాపర్టీస్ ని రీడ్ చేస్తాం ఇన్స్ట్రుమెంట్ తో. అగైన్ ఆల్ దిస్ ఇస్ అవర్ ఎలక్ట్రానిక్ టెక్నాలజీ. ఓకే, విల్ బర్న్ ద ఫ్యూయల్ అండ్ వి విల్ రీడ్ ద నాయిస్ ప్రాపర్టీస్. ఓకే, ఆ స్పెక్ట్రమ్ అంతా ఎలా వస్తుందంటే ఇలా ఇలా గీతలు గీతలు గీతల్లా వచ్చేస్తే అది నాయిస్. ఓకే, దాని నాయిస్ లెవెల్స్ ని రీడ్ చేసి దాని రాకింగ్ నాకింగ్ ప్రాపర్టీస్ ని రేట్ చేస్తాం. సరే, what I'll do, I'll burn the petrol and read its knocking properties. I'll keep those, that graph at one place. Okay, now I want to give whether it a rating, a number to tell whether it is a good quality or a bad quality petrol. So okay, so after taking the knocking noise levels of that test sample, okay, as a graph. I'll start doing one more experiment. In that experiment, what I'll do, I'll first take isooctane, and it is theoretically decided that this isooctane does not have any knocking. That is, knocking is zero and its octane rating is 100. Okay. Now to that isooctane, first I will add some 10% N-heptane. Okay. That 10% N-heptane means now the combination is 90 ml, for example, 90 ml isooctane and 10 ml N-heptane. Okay. Now, I'll find the knocking properties. Okay. I'll check whether it will match or not. No, it does not match. Now, I'll add much more. I'll add 10 more ml. It comes to 80-20. Okay. Now, the knocking properties does not match. Okay. Then I'll 10 more ml. Then the combination becomes 70 ml isooctane and 30 ml N-heptane. Now, the knocking properties matched. Now, what I have understood, the test sample graph and the graph of the combination of isooctane and N-heptane matched. Then what I'll do, I'll give my test sample octane rating as 70. Why? It contains 70% of isooctane. Okay, so its octane number is 70. Okay, no, if the mixture of N-heptane and isooctane is 40-60. Okay, isooctane and N-heptane is 40-60. Then what is the octane number? 40. Okay, that means the amount of isooctane present in that 100% of the composition is given as the octane number. If 80% of isooctane is present, the octane number is 80. Like that, I'll give the octane number. So how we have defined octane number or octane rating? It is the amount or percentage of isooctane present in a mixture of isooctane and N-heptane. Okay. Now, roll number 103. Good morning. 103 is absent today. 104. 105. I'm taking the attendance as well. 106, 7, 108, 109, 110, 111, 12, 13, 14, 15.
Yes, ma'am.
15, Shekhar. Okay, now tell me, Shekhar, the octane number of a fuel is given as, of a sample of petrol is given as 60. Okay, now can you tell me how much percentage of isooctane is present in that mixture and how much amount of N-heptane is present? ఏం అర్థం కాలేదా శేఖర్ నీకు?
నో మ్యామ్.
అసలు వింటున్నావా క్లాస్? ఆ ఏముంది, నా ప్రెజెంటేషన్ కన్నా ఈవిడ క్లాస్ చూస్తున్నావా?
నో మ్యామ్.
ఏమిటి, ఎందుకు అర్థమైందా లేదా చెప్పు. లేదా నేను నాకింగ్ ప్రాపర్టీస్ 100% నాకింగ్, మేడం ఈజ్ N-heptane. ఎప్పుడు గొడగొడగొడగొడ వాగుతుంది, అబ్బా రాట్లింగ్ నాయిస్. I want to on a very rainy day, okay, with good drizzle, okay, very lazily and lousily I wanted to sleep. Here comes my villain, my chemistry teacher. and lot of knocking, non stop. She keeps explaining something, something, and she's writing on the board and forcing me to write on in my notebook. So she's NHEP 10 now. Correct? So everyone there, not alone in the single person. Madam has 100% knocking, and I am the greatest fuel available on earth, which never burns. My octane rating is 100 because I never open my mouth and I never make any sound at all. If teacher shouts, grumbles, whatever she does, it is NHEP 10 composition. I am the benign ISO octane. No noise at all. What's this? Em cheppanu? Rendu molecules ni kalputunnanu. Entavi? NHEP 10 ISO octane. Sare enduku muraleka? మీరు ఇప్పుడు మీరు బైక్ వెళ్తున్న ఎప్పుడన్నా బయటకు వెళ్ళినప్పుడు మీరు థామ్ అని చప్పుడు చేయాలట, వెంటనే మీకు ఫైన్ వస్తుంది. ఇంకోసారి బయటకు తీసుకొస్తే కొడతాం అనాలి. అప్పుడు మీ పెట్రోల్ రేటింగ్ సరిగ్గా లేదు అని చెప్తారు. సో అలా తెలుసు, ఒక్కొక్కసారి మనం వెళ్తుంటే వెనకాల నుంచి కెరోసిన్ పోసేస్తారు ఆటోల్లో, ఓ పొగ వచ్చేస్తూ ఉంటుంది. పూర్ క్వాలిటీ ఆఫ్ ఫ్యూయల్ దట్ ఈస్ యూస్ విచ్ ఇస్ నాట్ ఇన్ కంపాటబుల్ టు ద ఐసి ఎంజిన్ ఆర్ మెషిన్ ఎట్ ఆల్. ఓకే, సో నేను ఇప్పుడు క్వాలిటీ ఆఫ్ పెట్రోల్ ని ఎలా రేట్ చేస్తాను చెప్పు శేఖర్. క్వాలిటీ ఆఫ్ పెట్రోల్ రేట్ చేయడానికి ఏంటి? హలో, క్వాలిటీ ఆఫ్ పెట్రోల్ ని ఎలా చెప్తాను? ఏ నెంబర్ నుంచి చెప్తాను రేటింగ్? బోర్డు మీద రాసాను, కనిపిస్తుందా?
ఆక్టేన్
ఆక్టేన్ రేటింగ్, కరెక్ట్, గుడ్, కరెక్ట్ గా చెప్పావు. ఆక్టేన్ రేటింగ్ ని నేను ఎలా ఇస్తున్నాను? A2 మాలిక్యూల్స్ నాకింగ్ ప్రాపర్టీస్ ని కన్సిడర్ చేసి ఆక్టేన్ రేటింగ్ ఇస్తున్నా చెప్పు. బోర్డ్ మీద ఉంది కదా, చదువు ఒకసారి. రాసావా నువ్వు ఇది నోట్స్ లో? రాయ్, వెంటనే రాయ్. నెక్స్ట్ రోల్ నెంబర్ 116, ప్రెసెంట్ ఆర్ అబ్సెంట్? 17.
Yes, ma'am. Good morning, ma'am.
Vaishnavi. Yes, ma'am. Chepu nana. AV2 molecules ni consider chesi knocking properties of petrol ni consider chestunna. Octane rating istunna chepu.
NHEP 10 and iso octane.
NHEP 10 and iso octane. Rendu molecules iskuni vaati knocking properties consider chesi nenu oka petrol ki rating istunna. Aa rating enti? Octane number. ఓకే, సో ఈ రెండు మాలిక్యూల్స్ తీసుకుని వాటి నాకింగ్ ప్రాపర్టీస్ ని స్టడీస్ చేసినప్పుడు ఏం అండర్స్టాండ్ చేసుకున్నాం? విచ్ హ్యాస్ 100% నాకింగ్? టెల్ మీ వైష్ణవి.
NHEP 10.
సో ఇఫ్ పెట్రోల్ శాంపుల్ హ్యాస్ NHEP 10 కాంపోజిషన్ ఇన్ ఎక్సెస్, ఓకే, హ్యాస్ నాకింగ్ ప్రాపర్టీస్ జస్ట్ లైక్ NHEP 10, ఇట్ ఈస్ అ గుడ్ క్వాలిటీ పెట్రోల్ ఆర్ అ బ్యాడ్ క్వాలిటీ పెట్రోల్? రామచంద్ర,
ఇఫ్ హై, ఇఫ్
NHEP 10 వాల్యూ హై ఉంటే
ఆక్టేన్ నెంబర్
పెట్రోల్ మంచిదా కాదా? ఏంటి వైష్ణవి, NHEP 10 వాల్యూ ఎక్కువ ఉంటే పెట్రోల్ క్వాలిటీ మంచిదా చెడ్డదా? పూర్ క్వాలిటీ పెట్రోల్, ఎందుకు? 100% నాకింగ్ కాబట్టి, అంతేనా? సో ఐసో ఆక్టేన్ నెంబర్ ఇస్ మోర్, అమౌంట్ ఇస్ మోర్ దెన్ ద క్వాలిటీ ఆఫ్ పెట్రోల్ ఇస్
గుడ్, మ్యామ్.
గుడ్ అమ్మయ్య, గుడ్ వైష్. ఓకే, నెక్స్ట్
117
18 ఇస్ అబ్సెంట్. మళ్ళా చాట్ బాక్స్ లో పెడతారు, ఐఎమ్ ప్రెసెంట్, మై వాయిస్ ఇస్, మై మైక్ ఇస్ నాట్ వర్కింగ్ అండ్ మై బ్రెయిన్ నెవర్ వర్క్స్. ఓకే, దట్స్ అ బ్యూటీ. చెప్పు నీరజ్. 119. గుడ్ మార్నింగ్. టెల్ మీ హౌ ఐ విల్ రేట్ డీజిల్ యూజింగ్ విచ్ రేటింగ్?
సెటెన్ రేటింగ్, మ్యామ్.
సెటెన్ రేటింగ్, కరెక్ట్. Okay, I'll give certain rating considering the knocking properties of which two molecules?
2-methyl naphthalene and hexadecane, ma'am.
n hexadecane and 2 methyl naphthalene. Correct. Okay. Now give me the definition of cetane rating. Did you write take down the definition?
Yes, ma'am.
Chepunana.
It is defined as the percentage of hexadecane present in a mixture of hexadecane and 2 methyl naphthalene.
Sorry. Now, which has 100% knocking and which has 0% knocking?
2 methyl naphthalene has 100% knocking, ma'am. N hexadecane has 0% knocking, ma'am.
Correct. Okay. Now, if I say that the cetane number of a diesel engine is 90, okay, then which is 90% and which is 10%? Tell me.
2 methyl naphthalene will be 90%, ma'am.
ఈ పాయింట్ మీకు అర్థం కావట్లేదు అనుకుంటా అవునా?
Yes, ma'am.
ఇప్పుడు సెటేన్ రేటింగ్ 90 అన్నాను అనుకో, ఇఫ్ ఐ సే ద సెటేన్ రేటింగ్ ఇస్ 90, దెన్ 90% ఆఫ్ ఎన్ఎక్సా డెకేన్ ఇస్ దేర్, ఓకే, వెరాస్ ద 2 మిథైల్ నాఫ్థలిన్ ఈస్ 10%. ఓకే, ఐ విల్ గివ్ ద సెటేన్ రేటింగ్ విత్ రెస్పెక్ట్ టు ద amount of hexadecane, okay, whereas for petrol I give octane rating with respect to the percentage of isooctane present. Ante enta isooctane unte dananta octane rating, enta n hexadecane unte dadi dan is cetane rating. Sare, so ippudu nenu cetane number 90 annanu anko, the meaning enti, a particular fuel composition lo, okay, నాకింగ్ ప్రాపర్టీస్ ఎలా ఉన్నాయి అంటే 90% హెక్సాడెకేన్ ది, ఓన్లీ 10% 2 మిథైల్ నాఫ్థలిన్ అని అర్థం. అంటే దాని లోపల కెమికల్ కాంపౌండ్ ఉందని కాదు, దానికి అన్ని అంతా నాకింగ్ ప్రాపర్టీ ఉందని అర్థం. సరే?
Yes, ma'am.
నేను ఇంకా టైం అయిపోయింది, సిలబస్ కూడా అయిపోవచ్చింది, కానీ మీకు అర్థం కావట్లేదు. సర్లే, sometimes my teaching defect, many a times your learning defect. You are not in a mood, you don't want to listen. You are in a mood, you would like to listen. Okay, okay. So here I'll conclude one more point. Okay, so I'll explain about the petrol octane rating in terms of its chemical structure. Okay, I hope you know about various, what it means by isomerism, okay? What is isomerism? Same molecular formula, but different structures is nothing but isomerism, okay? So, what you will see, why petrol undergoes very premature ignition, okay? We know that petrol is one fuel which is having boiling range of 40 to 120 degrees centigrade. That means it is a low boiling fuel. Okay, that's the first point we should know. What's the second point I should tell you here is, see, I understood that if that petrol burns very, very quickly, much faster than what I want, it leads to knocking. That means pre-ignition. I don't want petrol to burn very quickly. I don't want that to burn very, very fast, more than my demand. Okay? It means what? The petrol should contain such compounds which should not promote faster burning. Okay? They should only support slow and regulated burning. Okay? So, what should be the chemical composition of the petrol so that the burning is minimized or it does not take place randomly? It is studied that straight chain hydrocarbons will undergo faster burning as compared to branched or compounds having multiple bonds and aromatic compounds. Okay? and hence should be the composition of the petrol. Ante ade C5 composition unna molecules lo em cheptanu ante pentane undanko n pentane baddu adi enduku fast ga burn avutundi kabatti. Okay, isobutane is better. Okay, as compared to n pentane, same chemical formula ne kani ade compound ki branched structures unna, double bonds unna, ledha aromatic compounds unte edaithe fast burning of petrol ni promote cheyavo alanti molecules dantlo unte better. Okay, and hence the chemical composition and quality of petrol. If a sample of petrol has less number of straight chain hydrocarbons and more percentage of branched or alkenes or aromatic compounds, then the petrol will not undergo fast ignition or premature ignition, and its burning can be organized. Okay, and the petrol is supposed to be a good quality petrol. Okay, because it does not support premature ignition. Okay, so what is the relation between the quality of petrol and the chemical structure? So write down quality of petrol and chemical structure. So what is the thing? Structure of compounds, structure of components. Okay, subject of discussion. So I want petrol to burn reasonably at an organized rate of combustion. Okay, I does not want petrol to burn just like that. Okay, gas stove nu veligichavo. Okay, you have switched on the gas stove and you have a regulator. You want sim, you want high, and you want to switch it off. Okay, now by chance if your regulator has got some problem or your fuel has some problem, even if you put it in sim, if it is burning with a lot of flame, uncontrollable, which you don't want, then the quality of that fuel is poor. You should not use such things. Same is the case in the internal combustion machine. Okay, you wanted the petrol to burn at a regular rate, at an organized rate, so that how much you want energy, that much petrol only should burn. Okay, now by chance if the quality of petrol is poor, means when you say the quality of petrol is pure or impure depending upon its chemical components that are present in that sample of petrol. Okay, so what you say, knocking will be more in the case of petrol if it is having premature burning or ignition. And koncha vidike o mandipothundi. Okay, so knocking and the structure of the component, what you see, knocking is more in the case of petrol sample having straight chain hydrocarbons. Okay, because straight chain hydrocarbons burn much, much faster than branched chain hydrocarbons. Okay, branched chain hydrocarbons burn much faster than olefinic hydrocarbons. Okay, that these will burn much faster than aromatic hydrocarbon. Okay, Adwinda, everyone there. So in the case of petrol, what is the relation between the structure and knocking? Because petrol suffers premature ignition. Okay, and that premature ignition is resultant due to the internal chemicals that are present in that sample of petrol. Means what it says, straight chain petrol if the petrol sample has more straight chain molecules than the branched chain or olefins or aromatic hydrocarbons, then it does more knocking. Just like just now I told with you, N-heptane is a straight chain compound. Okay, what is the structure of N-heptane? Okay, 7 carbons arranged in a line. I'll write here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, this 7 carbons arranged in a line. Okay, N-heptane, because it is a straight chain hydrocarbon. Okay, it quickly starts burning, lost ignition, very less ignition temperature, still lot of burning and burning all together, and it does not help the fuel to burn in an ordered manner. So 100% knocking, its octane rating is zero. Okay, now the very important one which I have to tell you is that of iso-octane. Okay, iso-octane, and actually you should remember is that the chemical formula of iso-octane is also sometimes asked. So what is iso-octane? It is an hydrocarbon which is branched. Okay, what is the chemical structure? 2-2-4 trimethylpentane is iso-octane. This is important. Okay, 2-2-4 trimethylpentane is iso-octane. Okay, so how to write the structure of iso-octane? See, pentane means 5 carbons in a straight chain. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, and I number this as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. On the second carbon, I have 2 methyl groups. Okay, and on the fourth carbon, I have 1 more methyl group. Okay, so this branched chain hydrocarbon is iso-octane, which is having the normal name 2-2-4-trimethylpentane. That is IUPAC name of that. Okay, now you should realize. Now, why I'm giving octane rating? Because this iso-octane compound does not show much knocking at all. I arbitrarily assigned its knocking properties as zero. Ippudu, you should understand. If it is just N-octane, and a straight chain octane undanko, adi malla straight chain hydrocarbon. So it quickly undergoes burning and promotes premature ignition, leading to knocking. The same octane is now present as branched chain structure. Okay, that is 2-2-4 trimethyl pentane. Now this 2-2-4 trimethyl pentane is nothing but iso-octane. Okay, now because this is being branched, it does not burn much faster. Okay, so it will not promote any premature ignition, and hence is given octane rating 100. Okay, and hence is the discussion. Now, had it been N-octane, ide chemical formula tho straight ga rasam anko adi N-octane aipothundi. N-octane just like N-heptane chala rattling noise istundi. Enduku? Again, it's a straight chain hydrocarbon and it supports a lot of premature ignition, and hence is the rating of petrol. You understood this? This is a fond after question for mid and final exams generally. The chemical structure and the quality of a fuel. In the case of petrol, it is N-heptane and iso-octane. Greater the octane number, greater the quality of petrol. And what should be the chemical composition? For the same chemical formula, if the petrol contains more branched or olefinic or aromatic hydrocarbons than straight chain hydrocarbons, then the petrol sample does not undergo premature ignition and hence will not support knocking. That's the description. Okay. Next, I'll talk about the diesel engines. Okay. The next discussion is the chemical structure of diesel and its knocking. Diesel chemical structure or chemical composition and knocking. Okay, it is exactly the reverse. Okay, if straight chain hydrocarbons are more, then the knocking is less than branched chain, than olefinic, than aromatic hydrocarbon. Exactly the opposite sign you need to keep. Okay? Why is my question? It's very simple. In the beginning only we wrote on the in our notes that diesel gives knocking because of delayed ignition. We also know that diesel is one fuel which burns from 250 degrees to 320 degrees centigrade. That means it is a very, very high boiling liquid. Okay. Now, why it gives knocking? Because not because of more burning. It will never burn. It will take a lot of time to start burning and start giving the heat energy. Okay. So it's a common thing sometimes that when we try to switch on our cars particularly, that we keep on trying to handle it, but still the car doesn't start. Why? Delayed ignition. Why the delayed ignition in the case of diesel? Because again, I'll have to discuss about the chemical composition of it. Okay. See, it does not burn. I have already told with you, a fuel does not burn that fast when it contains more amount of aromatic compounds, okay, or more amount of olefinic hydrocarbons or branched chain hydrocarbons rather than straight chain hydrocarbons, okay. It's the same thing but in a different way. Now diesel should burn much faster and in much organized way, okay. Now how can I avoid delayed ignition? Okay, if the diesel contains more straight chain hydrocarbons than branched chain or olefins or aromatic compounds, then the diesel will not suffer much knocking. Okay, and hence is the cetane rating. So how does the cetane rating is given? You can just see it on the board. 2-methyl naphthalene. Okay, so what's the structure of 2-methyl naphthalene? It's an aromatic hydrocarbon. Okay, there are 2 naphthalene rings and there is 1-methyl group on the second position. So the structure of 2-methyl naphthalene. Now this 2-methyl naphthalene being aromatic in nature will not allow the burning of the fuel appropriately. Okay, it causes delayed ignition and hence its knocking is 100% and its presence in the diesel is not favored. Now, what I've told you is that the knocking properties of hexane decay. Hexane means 6, decane means 10. So, what is the total number of carbons? 16. So, 3H2 taken 14 times. CH3 is the chemical formula for hexane decay. In hexane, what you understand, this is a straight chain hydrocarbon, okay, containing 16 carbons in a straight line. Heavy molecular weight hydrocarbon, still aliphatic in nature. Still, it has a straight structure, okay. Straight structure allows quick burning of the fuel and not allow diesel to suffer ignition delay. Okay, so its knocking is equal to zero. Its knocking is equal to zero, and its set-in rating is 100. Okay, its set-in rating is 100. Set-in number is 100. So this is the relation between the structure of the fuel and the knocking properties. Okay, that's the discussion. I wanted to finish much more, but 2 to 3, please ensure your presence. We'll finish this. We'll finish, and I'll start with biodiesel as well. Okay, so this is the one. 5 more minutes time is there. Actually, I can teach few more, but I think sir is waiting for the blackboard. So, intavarku ardhamainda. Okay, and I'll start taking that. Okay, understood. Please note it. Chappadaniki bold untundi. Revision chesetappudu chaala easy. Quality of petrol octane rating, quality of diesel cetane rating. Okay, petrol octane rating ni two molecules ni knocking properties of two molecules ni anukun chestanu. N heptane, isooctane. Isooctane percentage ekkuvunna fuel ki dani octane number corresponding ga ekku untundi. So greater quality of petrol. Sare, so definition of octane rating entante, it is a percentage of isooctane present in a mixture of isooctane and n-heptane. Adhe definition malla cetane rating ichchandi. Okay, what is cetane rating? It is given for to evaluate the quality of diesel. I'll consider the knocking properties of two molecules, 2-methyl naphthalene, n-heptane, n-hexadecane. Sare, cetane rating definition enti, it is the percentage of n-hexadecane present in a mixture of 2-methyl naphthalene and n-hexadecane. ఎప్పుడైనా గుర్తుపెట్టుకోండి, ఆక్టేన్ నెంబర్ అని ఒక నెంబర్ ఇచ్చారంటే అంత అమౌంట్ ఆఫ్ ఐసో ఆక్టేన్ ఉన్నట్టు. సెటేన్ నెంబర్ ఒక నెంబర్ ఇచ్చారు అంటే అంత పర్సంటేజ్ ఆఫ్ ఎన్హెక్సా డెకేన్ ఉన్నట్టు. సరే, కాబట్టి ఈజీ డిస్కషన్. సరే, ఈ నాకింగ్ ఎందుకు చేస్తుంది పెట్రోల్ అంటే ఫాస్ట్ బర్నింగ్. కావాల్సిన రేట్ కన్నా ఎక్కువ ఫాస్ట్ గా బర్న్ అవుతే అది ప్రీమెచ్యూర్ ఎగ్నిషన్ వలన అది నాకింగ్. అదే కేసు డీజిల్ కి వస్తే డిలేడ్ ఇగ్నిషన్ వలన. సరే, అంటే అది ఒక పట్టాన బర్న్ అవ్వదు కాబట్టి. సో దాని కెమికల్ కాంపోజిషన్స్ ని తీసుకుని దాని ఎందుకు అది ప్రీమెచ్యూర్ ఇగ్నిషన్ అవుతుంది పెట్రోల్ ఎందుకు డీజిల్ అవ్వదు అని చెప్పడానికి ఒక చిన్నది ఒక లైన్ ఉంది. ఏంటది, ఒకవేళ పెట్రోల్ తీసుకున్నాం అనుకో, దాంట్లో స్ట్రైట్ చైన్ హైడ్రో కార్బన్స్ ఉంటే, సింపుల్ లాజిక్ ఏంటి, స్ట్రైట్ లైన్ హైడ్రో కార్బన్స్ ఉంటే ఫాస్ట్ బర్న్ అవుతుంది, అదే అరోమాటిక్ అవన్నీ కంపౌండ్స్ ఉంటే అంత ఫాస్ట్ గా బర్న్ కాదు. సరే, సో ఈ ఆర్డర్ ఏదైతే ఇచ్చానో అదే సంగతి. ఓకే, సో దాని అది ఎగ్జాక్ట్లీ డిఫరెంట్ ఉంటుంది. పెట్రోల్ కి లెస్ అమౌంట్ ఆఫ్ స్ట్రైట్ చైన్ హైడ్రో కార్బన్స్ కావాలి, మోర్ అమౌంట్ ఆఫ్ అరోమాటిక్ ఆర్ బ్రాంచ్ చైన్ హైడ్రో కార్బన్స్ ఉంటే బెటర్. అదే నువ్వు డీజిల్ కి వస్తే మోర్ స్ట్రైట్ చైన్ ఉంటే బెటర్, లెస్ అరోమాటిక్ బ్రాంచ్ ఉంటే బెటర్. అలా ఆక్టేన్ రేటింగ్ అండ్ సెటేన్ రేటింగ్. ఓకే, టుడే 3 to 4 ప్లీజ్ జాయిన్ ఫర్ కంక్లూజన్ ఆఫ్ దిస్ టాపిక్ అండ్ గేషియస్ ఫ్యూయల్స్ అలాంగ్ విత్ అన్ ఇంట్రొడక్షన్, ఆల్మోస్ట్ ఐ థింక్ ఇంట్రొడక్షన్ టు బయోడీజిల్ యాజ్ వెల్. ఓకే, so let me answer your attendance, and as soon as you answer your attendance you can leave the session. Okay, good day to all of you, and join chemistry class by 2 o'clock. Okay, the pen. Roll number 61, 62, 63.
Present, ma'am.